Welcome aboard, crew. You may not have realized it, but you've been living on the most epic spaceship in the universe. Earth! Yep, Earth is like a giant spaceship zooming through space at 67,000 miles per hour around the sun. And guess what? We can't pull over to refuel or restock on supplies. Earth has to take care of itself, because, like any good spaceship, everything we need to survive is already on board. But in order to keep this spaceship running smoothly, we need to understand how it works. In this course, we'll study environmental science, explore the biodiversity on Earth, and learn how Earth's four spheres work together to keep our planet healthy, balanced, and thriving. So buckle up, crew! It's time to start exploring how Earth's systems work together and how we can protect this amazing spaceship we all share. Let's get started. This is your first time taking an environmental science course, you've probably heard of environmental science before. Based on what you already know, how would you define environmental science? Pause the video here and record your prediction. Did you come up with some ideas? Maybe you thought about the study of ecosystems, or you thought about protecting natural resources. Or maybe you even thought about studying problems like pollution. Environmental science is all of this and more. Environmental science is the study of how the environment works and how humans interact with the environment. It's an interdisciplinary field that looks at the relationship between living organisms and their physical surroundings. It also studies how human activities impact these natural systems. In this course, we'll learn about the four critical systems that keep spaceship Earth functioning. These systems are often called the four spheres of the environment, and each one is essential in supporting all of the life we see on our remarkable planet. Earth, like a spaceship, is a closed system. A closed system refers to a system where matter does not enter or leave, but energy can be exchanged with the outside environment. For Earth, this means that while energy from the sun comes in and heat is radiated back into space, the physical matter, like water, air, and land, stays within the system. This means that all of the matter we've got has to stay balanced. And that balance? It's thanks to Earth's four spheres. We've got no pit stops, no extra supplies, everything we need is already on board. And the only way to keep this ship flying smoothly? All the systems have to work together. The four main systems, or spheres, of the environment on Earth are the geosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere, and biosphere. If we break down each of these terms into its root words, we can start to get a picture of what each term means. Using these root words, what do you think each sphere contains? The geosphere is the solid Earth, from rocky mountains to sandy beaches and even the magma deep underground. The hydrosphere is all of the water on Earth, whether it's in oceans or rivers, in the clouds, or even in soil. The atmosphere is the air around us. This unique mixture of gases is critical for supporting life on Earth. Speaking of life, the biosphere contains all living organisms, from the biggest whales to the tiniest bacteria. Biodiversity refers to the variety of life on Earth, including plants, animals, fungi, and microorganisms. In other words, it's the richness of life on Earth. And each species plays a role in keeping our planet's systems running smoothly. Here's where things get interesting. The geosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere, and biosphere are constantly interacting with one another. That river you see? It's part of the hydrosphere, shaped by the geosphere, feeding the biosphere, and affected by gases in the atmosphere. Because Earth is a closed system, matter is recycled through these four spheres, changing forms in a delicate balance. It all depends on what is needed to keep the environment healthy. In environmental science, we'll learn about the interactions between the four spheres of the environment and how humans can impact the environment. Knowing that Earth is a closed system, why do you think learning about its environment is important? Pause the video here and record your thoughts. Because Earth is a closed system, the matter in each sphere cannot be replaced. The resources we have on Earth have to be protected and used intentionally in order to sustain life for generations to come. Additionally, all of Earth's systems, the four spheres, have to work together to keep things running. And if something goes wrong in one sphere, it can mess up the whole system. For example, if the atmosphere gets too much pollution, it affects cloud formation, which can lead to acid rain in the hydrosphere. That rain falls on the geosphere, affecting plants and animals in the biosphere. See how everything's connected? The first step to solving environmental problems like acid rain is to understand how the environment works. In the first semester of environmental science, we'll lay the foundation by learning how systems on Earth work. In doing so, we'll explore some fascinating phenomena to learn about our environment. Many of these opportunities will be found in your lesson activities, so be sure not to skip these. To start, we'll zoom in and out on the different ecological levels of organization. From diving underwater into a kelp forest, to tracking an invasive mongoose species in Hawaii, we'll harness our curiosity to ask questions like an environmental scientist. In the geosphere, we'll unearth ancient fossils in the Santana Formation, explore the Ring of Fire, and examine why Louisiana's coastline is disappearing. In the hydrosphere, we'll reveal the properties of the miracle molecule that makes life possible, water. We'll trace the path of water through the hydrosphere in all of its forms, from frozen ice caps to the mysterious depths of the open ocean. Then, we'll travel up into space as we explore the atmosphere. We'll track hurricanes and the air conditions that form these massive storm systems. And we'll study the greenhouse effect, tracking greenhouse gas emissions and temperatures over hundreds of years. And finally, we'll delve into the dazzling biodiversity on planet Earth as we explore how conditions in the geosphere, hydrosphere, and atmosphere interact to create different biomes. From the freezing Arctic tundra to the lush jungle in the Amazon rainforest, we'll investigate how life has adapted to thrive on all corners of the map. We'll also examine some of the ecological challenges facing each biome today. Remember, learning about the environment is the critical first step to developing solutions for these problems. By the end of this course, you'll be on your way to understanding the connections between Earth's systems and the impact of human activities. Then, if you choose to take the second semester environmental science course, you'll have the opportunity to use what you learn to think critically about solving environmental challenges. You'll be equipped with the knowledge and skills to come up with innovative, science-based solutions. Who knows? You might just become one of the problem solvers who helps protect our planet for future generations. As we went through the lesson today, we learned all about environmental science. As you move through this course, you'll build a foundational knowledge of the four spheres of the environment. As we learn about this incredible closed system, we'll begin to understand the connections between land, water, air, and life as we explore the fascinating phenomena on our planet. I can't wait to dive in! But you're not just going to learn the science. You're going to begin to ask the important questions. How can we keep the biosphere healthy? How can we protect our water? How can we make sure our atmosphere stays clean and the geosphere stable? Environmental science gives you the tools to become the next generation of problem solvers. Until next time, remember, learning about the environment will give you the tools to protect our shared spaceship called Earth. You're a force of nature, so keep sparking the changes that you want to see. Hey, hey.